noise. I once emceed a race and they gave me a bullhorn. Strangely, though, I wasn't invited back the next year. Friday, the Salvation Army asked me to help out with the Red Kettle campaign. Do I get a bell? That was my only question. Yes? Then I'm in. Put me anywhere you like. So there I was outside the Pick and Save on Van Buren, taking over for Tim Van Vorn, who told me the noon to one crowd was, quote, very generous. Look, folks, I happen to speak Van Vorn, so I took that as a personal challenge to raise more money than he did. Apron on tight, bell in hand, I set out to be a 60-minute money-making machine. Wasn't a lot of clanging, though, which at first I blamed my unusual ringing style, sort of reggae meets dinner bell rhythm. Some gave a lot, thanks to those who did. But what I noticed most is that those who didn't give seemed uncomfortable just walking by. And I'm here to tell you, you shouldn't. You're not being judged. Some people just don't carry cash. That's very common in this debit card world. Many have already given or do so less publicly with a check instead of change. Some honestly can't spare anything. Trust me, people understand, especially these days. You're going to see a lot of those red kettles in this week up to Christmas. If you want to give, great. That's what they're there for. But please, please, don't feel bad about not giving. Seriously. And please don't walk by and pretend they're not there. Don't avert eye contact with bell ringers. And know that their greetings of Merry Christmas are not donor conditional. In unreturned, Merry Christmas or Happy Holidays.